What's up, everyone? It's DV. We got a new game jam. If you recall, the other month I had a $2,000 game jam for Core Games. So Core is a multiverse platform, a lot like Roblox. So why everyone keeps comparing Core to Roblox is just like Roblox, you can easily make games with their engine. They've got really cool tools that make it really easy for designers and non-developers to actually make games very easily. They have like frameworks and stuff. So if you want to make like a quick shooter, you don't even need to know how to code. You could just start making maps. And so that's why a lot of people actually compare it, and you can easily launch it games very quickly. That's what's really appealing about this. So you don't have to like download and install stuff every time. So like in other platforms like Epic Games Launcher and stuff, you know, you have to like install stuff. You got to like, you know, like Steam, you got to install stuff each time you want to play like a new game. But Core is completely free to play, just like Roblox. So you can find a bunch of free games to play. It is PC only right now. So I am actually hosting a second game jam. So this is actually my second one in a row. So we're going to actually do another one. I had a lot of fun the last time, and I know a lot of you were actually bummed you couldn't actually make it into the last game jam. So because of that, I'm actually host another one, but I'm going to make it a little easier this time. This time, instead of actually making it so it's a game jam where you have to actually program and, you know, script an entire game, I'm actually going to be doing a world building game jam. So what that means, what does world building mean? Just like in Roblox, you know, when you make maps and levels, so this is like a world, right? So someone created this, they put a skybox in here, they added like, you know, buildings, they added terrain, they textured it, and they made it look really, really cool. And they, you know, adjusted the lighting, they added these torches. So this is an example of a great map. So your world's going to be actually fantasy like this. So, you know, it doesn't actually have to have gameplay in it, although, you know, it'd be nice if you actually added a couple things you can do in it, but that is not the requirement. The requirement here for this game jam is to make some awesome looking map designs and worlds. So like I said, you could actually be fantasy or you could be sci-fi. You could make whatever you want as long as it looks good, and you're going to be judged on your creativity, you know, lighting, all that kind of stuff, just to see how well you actually, you know, if your map looks really cool, then awesome. Ideally, we'd like to have it like first person or third person so we can kind of easily, you know, roam around the world and check it out. Top down maps aren't really going to be a good choice for you. So, you know, definitely try to keep it like third person or first person mode. And again, it doesn't have to be a shooter. It doesn't have to be any kind of gameplay whatsoever in it. Although it might be kind of cool to actually have, you know, some shooter kind of, like if you use a shooter framework, I would highly recommend that. First person or third person, or even CTF or whatever. It could be any game mode, but ideally try to use one of the frameworks just so we can have a little bit of gameplay in it. But it's not required, like I said. So if you just want to make like a really cool looking world with, you know, terrain and objects and stuff, you can do that. So I'm going to show you a couple of other games to give you some ideas of what we're talking about when we talk about world building. So the game I'm showing right now is Kingdom Fall, and I'm going to go head out to a couple other games real quick. All right, so this is another example of a world where they actually made like kind of like a cartoony looking shader. So you can see how like the world has like outlines and stuff, and it has a little bit of a cartoony feel with a little bit, and it's just really colored differently, so it's got unique lighting. This one's actually a survival game. It's kind of cool. This is another world, right? So you got like a base, you got like these crazy alien things, you got like these like, it's like flaky things kind of coming down from the sky, and it's actually fun. So, you know, definitely check out the games that are on the platform if you want to, but, you know, especially for inspiration. But I'm going to show you a couple other ones. So this one's a great one for more of a sci-fi kind of Halo-ish style world. So this is another awesome map. You know, I'm actually, this is my reindeer, by the way. I will actually be giving one of these away on my channel soon. So, you know, definitely check out my Core Games channel. So it's DV Plays Core. You can subscribe to it. I will link it in the description if you want to check it out. But check this map out. It is crazy cool looking. They've got like a ski lift over here. So like there's like skiing. There's an obby. It's actually a full-on obby. So let's go up here. So check this out. This is such a cool looking map. So this is from the top down. So I'm going to actually go down on my horse. I'm going to use my horse as a sled. But oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, dude. That's so crazy. Anyway, so this is what we're talking about, though, is from a world building standpoint. I mean, someone had to actually do the snow. They had to put the trees in. They made an obby and stuff. So you could actually do an obby, too, if you really wanted to. You don't have to. You might get some bonus points for doing that. But we're really looking at the world building aspects of it. We're really excited to see what you create. Last time, we had some crazy entries. And I really loved seeing all the creations. And we had a blast judging. And we'll actually have a People's Choice Award. So if you, you know, so if you don't win, you still have a chance for the Discord community to actually vote on your project. So definitely, you know, consider checking out the Core if you're on PC and want a chance at winning some big bucks. So winning prizes will be Amazon gift cards. So the game jam starts on December 17th. So you got a little bit of time to get prepped and, you know, kind of get ramped up on the engine before it starts. And submissions will close on the 7th of January. So January 7th. So you got a bit of time. You got like 3+ weeks. And our judging will start as soon as submissions close. And then we're going to actually announce the winners on the 14th of January. So that is when you can expect to, see the announcements, and I will be announcing the winners, and winners will be announced on my DV Plays Core channel. So if you haven't subscribed to that channel, definitely check it out. Like I said, so this is our breakdown for winners. First place winner will receive a $1,000 gift card to Amazon. Second place is going to receive $300 gift card, and third place, $100 gift card. Fourth through fifth will receive $50 gift cards, and then we have a People's Choice winner who will receive a $100 gift card. Either way, I hope you consider participating, and if you can't, if you're on mobile, I totally get it. One of these days, but unfortunately, it would be really hard for you to use the map editor with mobile. Even on Roblox, if you were trying to use like Roblox Studio, you'd be in big trouble trying to do on mobile. So unfortunately, maybe once you get a computer. And I'll continue to have game jams. I'm actually probably going to make this a regular event for the channels, and just to give you all something to do and a chance to win some cool prizes. It is my way of giving back to the community. And again, I really believe in Core. I think it's a great platform, especially if you're looking for something that's a little bit different than Roblox every now and then. And again, I'm not, just so you know, like I love Core and Roblox. You know, like you can play them both. You don't have to be exclusive. Just like a lot of Roblox players play Fortnite and such, you can play Core still and still play and love Roblox. You know, it's not a big deal. And I don't think you're betraying Roblox in any way by playing another platform. Just like if you were going to play, you know, Among Us for a bit, that's kind of the, you know, that's the thing with playing Core. So I hope you consider joining this event. If you're at least 13, you can actually join the Discord. It is discord.gg/dvplays, or you can follow me on Twitter at Dark Viper, and I'll be posting announcements when we actually start the event then. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you in game. Peace.